Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to cover another interesting SQL question which is asked in the Flipkart Data Analyst SQL interview. So the question is, you have a table called sequence numbers where you have the columns ID and number, and you have some consecutive IDs and with some numbers placed in it. However, this is the output you need to return. So number with the column number and few rows, few numbers present in the input table. So this question has to be solved using four ways. First one is using the row number function. Second one is using the self join methods. Third one is using recursive CTE, and fourth one is using lag or lead function. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and understand what is the logic and what is the required logic to get this required output, and how to solve this using all these four methods. So the question here is, you need to return the numbers which appeared more than two times consecutively. So you have four you have these numbers 20, and here if you see, it appeared four times consecutively, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in the output 20 is present, and again 24 is has occurred more than two times, that is in 6, 7, 8. So it appeared three times consecutively, so 24 is returned. So 20 and 24 is returned. So to get this output, we need to assign a group number to this particular data set. So whenever a sequence is present, you need to assign a group number. So for the first four digits, since it is a same number is appearing multiple times, we have to assign a particular group number to this. And again 22, we'll have to assign a particular group number. And for 24, you'll have to assign a particular group number. And again 20 appeared, but it's another sequence, so another group number. So using the four methods which we have discussed earlier, that is using the row number function, self join, recursive CTE, and lag or lead function. So using all those methods, you need to provide return this group number. So that is the logic behind this. So once you return the group number, it is easy to calculate the number which has appeared more than two times consecutively, because you can do the group by this group number and this number. And if it's greater than, if you can check the particular count of rows for this combination, and if it is greater than 2, you can return these numbers. But the main challenge is you need to return this column called group number. So that is the main challenge. So now let's see how to return this group numbers using the first one is using the row number function. So I have already written the queries. So here the row number function. So first thing, I will create a row number based on partition by the number and order by ID. So when I run this row number function, you will get in this way. So for every number and based by in the order by the ID, you will assign the row number. So for 20, for ID 1, you will assign row number as 1. For ID 2, you will assign it as 2. ID 3, you will assign it as 3. And ID 4, you will assign it as 5. And for 9, it is 5. And similarly for 22, 1. And for 24, 6, 7, 8, in ascending order, it is 1, 2, 3. So this is, we have applied the row number. And now, as we discussed earlier, we need to fetch the group number. So the group number we have to fetch. So how do we fetch this? So we have to subtract the ID and the row number. So 1 minus 1 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, 3 minus 3 is 0, and 4 minus 4 is 0, and 9 minus 5 is 4. Okay, so now I have created, so this is the next part of the CTE. So I have subtracted the ID and the row number, and now what I'll do, select star from CTE. So this will give us the group number. Sorry, select start from group data. So this will give us the group number as we discussed. So for the first four rows, the group number 0 is assigned, and for 20, again for the fifth row, since it is another sequence, another group number is assigned. And for 22, only one number is there, so another group number is assigned. And for 24, 6, 7, 8, group number 5 is assigned. So it doesn't matter. So as shown earlier, we might not require 1, 2, and 3 group numbers. We can assign, put any group numbers, but the group number should be in such a way that it should distinguish the sequence. So now we have retrieved the group number. So for every group number and the number combination, we'll have to see, let's see if the count. So this is the query I have written. So select number from group data. So this is the group data, group by number and group number. So group by number and group number. So for 20 and 0, how many rows are there? So when we do this group by and count, how many rows are there? So count of 1 greater than or equal to 3. So when you run this, this is what you get. So now 20 and 24 we have written. So again reiterating the logic. So for row number, first you calculate the row number for every number and ID. So partition by for every number and in the ascending order of the ID, you assign a row number and take the difference between the the ID and the row number. So then you can get a, then the group number will be created. And for the group number, you can for the number and group number combination, you calculate the count of rows. So this way you will get the 20 and 24. Okay. So the next way is using recursive CTE. So recursive CTE also, so main logic in the recursive CTE what we use is, so we have the select start from sequence number. So here in the recursive CTE, what we do is for every row, we'll see if the previous row is the same or not. So here for row number one, I mean for the ID one, the previous number is not there. So we'll assign a group number as one. And for ID two also, so for ID two, we'll check whether the previous number is same as this number. Okay. So if the previous row number, previous row data is same as this data, then we assign the same group number. Okay. This will continue as long as the previous row number and the current row number is the same. Okay. So this, the group number one will be assigned to all the four rows, because row number 2 value is equal to 1, 3 is equal to 2, and 4 is equal to 3. For row number 5, since the 22 and 20 are not same, we will increment the group number. Okay, so that is the logic. So whenever the previous row and the current row data is not there, is not the same, we'll increment the group, we'll increment the group number. So that is what we have done using the recursive CTE. So we all know in recursive CTE, the first part is to identify the anchor member. So first part here, we have identified the anchor member as first row where the ID is 1. So when you run this, you will get the first row. And now what I have done, since I explained the logic, we are checking with the previous row number, right? So sequence number, the initial data set, I am joining with the recursive CTE to check the previous row. So sn.id, so sn.id is here, row number 2, I mean the ID 2. So ID 2, we are comparing with ID 1. So that's why sn.id is equal to r.id plus 1. Okay. So here we are comparing the current row with the previous row. And again the logic we have written, if both the numbers are same, then whatever group number is there for the previous row, that row, that group number will be assigned. Else we are incrementing the group number. Okay. So in this way, when we run this recursive CTE, this is what we get, select star from recursive CTE. So in this way, when you run the recursive CTE, you will get a group number assigned to the entire sequence. Okay. So again, we have now group number is assigned. So now again, what will we do? For the number and group number combination, we will see the total row count is greater than or equal to 3. If it is greater than or equal to 3, we are returning that number. So now if you run this, we are returning 20 and 24. So in this way, you need to use the recursive CTE. So basically, here what we are trying to do is comparing the current row and the previous row. So you can also think, so since I have explained the logic, current row and the previous row comparison, you can also think of the lead and lag function, right? So that we can, let's, in the lead and lag function also, let's see how to do that. But the next method is using the self join. So the next way is using the lag function. So here in the recursive, in the self join, if you remember, I'm trying to compare the current row with the previous row. If both are same, then I'm assigning 0, else 1. So here also I'll do the same thing, but instead of doing a left join, I'll use the lag function. So we all know what a lag function is. So we are using if the lag function based on the order by AD. Suppose if the current number is equal to the previous number, again, then it is 0, else it is 1. Okay. So now I am doing the select with the lag. So again, we have received, we have got this output. So 1, 0, 0. So here also, this is also the same output we have received earlier, but using the left join, self join we have received. Now here using the lag function, we are receiving the same output. Okay. And now again, with this is new group column, I'll do a cumulative sum. So once I do a cumulative sum, this is what I get. Again, I'll get the required group number. So the required group number I have got, and again the same concept here. So for every number and group number combination, we'll check the row count. If the row count is greater than or equal to 3, we'll return that number. So in this way, we can use the lag function also to retrieve the required output. So hope you all like this four solutions. The first solution is using the row number, and the second solution is using recursive CTE, and third solution is using the self join, fourth solution is using the lag function. So the concept of lag function, self join and recursive CTE is the same, that which is you are trying to compare the current row with the previous row. So the comparison between current row and previous row using these three methods. But for the row number function, this is a different logic altogether. But at the end, you are trying to assign a particular group number to a particular sequence. So hope you all like this video. If you like this video, please click on the like button so that it will reach to more audience who are looking out for more SQL questions. And also click on subscribe button so that my next video, you'll get a notification. So thank you. Have a nice day.